I'm here at the Pro Fight Shop in Hollywood, where besides being a place where you could get all kinds of fighting gear for boxing, MMA, karate, judo, jiu-jitsu, you name it, you also can hear some entertaining stories. Check this interview out. Man, do you know Evander?
Huh?
Are you related?
No, we're not related. We spell our names different and it's actually pronounced different. But everybody says that. Holyfield, I give up. It's not Holyfield, it's Hollyfield.
Hollyfield?
Yeah, Hollyfield.
Are you from the Beverly Hills side of the family?
Yeah, you could call it that. Do you see that house he had in Georgia? Oh, man,
he lost it, right?
He lost it, yeah.
Unfortunately, too many athletes, they spend
well, they
a little above
spend too much money, man.
Partying.
Yeah.
Partying and...
Women and babies and all that. See, every time a woman gets pregnant by one of those guys, there's a jackpot. Yeah.
They
had there was a NBA basketball player. This girl said, "You got me pregnant." And he looked and he said, "I've never seen you in my life."
Yeah.
And you know what happened?
What happened?
Her girlfriend fucked them and took the condom off and froze the sperm and put it in her girlfriend.
Oh. And it worked?
Yeah.
And did she get paid?
They found out about it later on. He didn't get paid. No.
If I'm not mistaken, was it Sean, Rain Man? What's his name, Sean?
No, it wasn't.
No. But I'm talking about
you're
him.
You're talking about...
He had 13 kids from like 10 different
Sean
women.
Sean Kemp.
Sean Kemp.
Yeah, Sean Kemp.
He was
had
busy.
A baby in every city.
Yep.
Man. Every city he played and he knocked a girl up. But he was stupid, man.
The other... But I know other NBA players that pay women off to keep them quiet and they buy them a house and a car, but... That's
Howard did that. Howard had a kid and he paid off and got the hell out of it. But isn't that an amazing story, man?
It is.
Tied that baby up.
Well, I got better stories for you. What they do sometimes, they'll go to a hotel room, knock on the door, and
call them groupies.
Wait, no, it's a mother and daughter group. And I've seen, I kind of see them in action. They go into the thing and the girl sleeps with the athlete.
Mm-hmm.
And then the mom calls and goes, "If you don't give me $100,000 right now, I'm going to report you to the cops because my daughter's 15.
Underage, yeah.
But it's not, but they scared the crap out of him. And he runs and he gives them the money just to shut up. Here's $60,000.
That's happened to Lawrence Taylor not that long ago, remember?
Yeah, but she was a prostitute. Yeah, that's different. Yeah, I'm talking about a mom-daughter scheme.
Yeah, so you got to watch it when you got money, man. I'm telling you.
The biggest celebrities I know are the loneliest people. They have no friends because they can't trust no one.
Yeah, they can't trust anybody.
You can't trust no one. That's why if I'm around someone famous, you can't ask for a pencil. You can't ask for a nickel. You can't ask for... Because if you ask, you become like everybody else and you're out of the circle.
Mm-hmm.
So don't ask for anything. Just be yourself and be cool.
Don't ask, don't tell.
No, that's something else.
Yeah, I know. I was just thinking about that.
But it's hard for them to date because if the girls know who they are, it's a done deal right there.
Yeah.
That's why you got to...
But they get some fine girls. You know these girls, you know what they do? They find out what hotel these guys are going to be living in, and they come out with their mini skirts and their beautiful women, man. I'm telling you, they're best top of the line with mini skirts on and their pumps.
I was just in England. Yeah, you should have seen what these Olympians had waiting in line. And I was telling the people in England, wow, the women here are beautiful. And he goes, no, these are the pros, and they're just here for the Olympics.
Yeah, that's right. They're groupies, man. That's right.
So what advice do you have for athletes about dating? What dating advice do you have for them?
Be smart, man. Don't be stupid. Don't be a sucker, man. Don't just because they... I know it's temptation is strong when you see a woman with those mini skirts on, those pumps and those booties and all of that, you're weak. You know, a woman's got power over a man. I saw an old movie with Barbara Streisand.
Looks like a man.
Yeah, no, not Barbara Streisand, Barbara Stanwyck. This is a movie that was back in the 30s. And she went to this old guy, this philosopher, and he told her, said, "Look, you are a woman, and a woman has power over a man. You have to use that power that you have over men." So she snuck on a train. And the security guy said, "I got to take you girls in." So she pulls up her leg. "Is anything that I could do to keep you from taking me to jail?" And all of a sudden, you see the guy taking his gloves off, and she gets busy with him. Then she goes to Chicago, hits up on the boss.
And nothing has changed since the 30s,
huh? But that time, she fucked her way all the way to the top, man.
It happens.
Became top dog there, man. Because a man's weakness is pussy. Look what happened to all of these guys that got taken down. Mike Tyson. With the rape, went to jail.
Right.
Well, so many of these guys, man, they get weak for
that. Was very questionable,
even
that whole
Jimmy
case.
Swagger, man, this evangelist, man, this prostitute said he beat her. He wanted to be beat with
I
a
remember.
Wet towel.
Don it wasn't
King,
worth it.
Yeah.
Don King, I know a heavyweight champion, the FOFA championship, and Don King only gave him $10,000.
Yeah.
Well, he probably made $10 million.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can't do that to kids.
Don King knew who to fuck with. There were certain fighters that wouldn't let him get away.
Yeah, they shot up his house. They blew up his house.
Well, Don King murdered a guy, you know.
I know.
Did time in prison. And when the police rolled up on him, he still had the pistol.
Well, he shot him in the back because he was a bookie and a guy would have murdered him. I know the story.
In Cleveland, Ohio.
I'm surprised you know the story. Oh, wait, were you the one who arrested him?
I'm a historian, man. When it comes to history, man, I'm right up there. I'm really into that history.
I just came back from London. Mm-hmm. I covered the Olympics. Mm-hmm. U.S. Failed in boxing. Partially, they got robbed. But you can't say that about 12 fighters. Why do you think
They didn't show a lot of boxing on...
That's shame on NBC. Because NBC said the most viewers are women, and women, if they see boxing, click the channel, which I disagree.
Well, yeah, because they showed a lot of gymnastics and a lot of
with the ladies
track
like,
and
swimming.
Yeah, it wasn't a lot of boxing like back in the day. One of the greatest boxing teams that came about was the 1976 team in Montreal.
You're right.
All of those guys. You had, what's that guy from Brooklyn?
You had Leon Spinks and his brother.
You had the Spinks brothers. You had Sugar Ray Leonard. What's this cat's name?
Davis was on the team, too.
There was another guy. I can't think of his name. Mark Greeland. Is that right? You remember Greeland? The guy out of Brooklyn. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I remember...
Terrell Biggs. You remember Terrell Biggs?
Yeah. And those were the glory days. Yeah. But today, if a kid's 17 and he's talented, he's going pro.
Yeah.
And I can't blame him because why be in a program until you're 21 and then you're not guaranteed anything? You don't win. You're 4 years, you could have... Your peers already have 10, 15 fights, or 5 professional fights.
And don't forget, Evander Holyfield was on that Olympic team. He got robbed, man. You know, they took his thing away.
His gold.
Took his gold.
And the opponent on the stage said, Evander, this is your...
Yeah, that's right. Evander got robbed, man.
Oscar De La Hoya against Julio Cesar Chavez. You were working that night at a quinceañera?
Right. Was that working at a Mexican quinceañera. And when the fight was over, a lot of the latecomers came in. They were very upset. They said the fight was fixed.
They were crying with tears?
Yeah, with tears, man. They were upset over that, man. They couldn't believe it, man. This woman even, the fight was fixed.
What do you think? Did De La Hoya really beat him?
De La Hoya whipped his ass, man. So what De La Hoya did was say, okay, you don't believe I whipped his ass the first time. Give me a second fight. And the second fight, he just ate him up, man.
Why did they refuse to believe that De La Hoya could be?
Because he's an icon.
He's human.
Mexican nationals, they believe in their own culture. See, Chavez is a white boy as far as the Mexicans are concerned. They don't accept him as a true Mexican.
De La Hoya?
De La Hoya, yeah, that's right. Because he wasn't born in Mexico, man. That's right. That's how it is, man. Either you are. You're not, man. Yeah.
But he's one of the greatest ever.
Yeah.
Won gold at the Olympics in 92. Came
that's right.
on and
the golden boy.
Fought everybody.
You got to put him in there, too. He had some hell of a fights, man.
Fernando Vargas, he beat
right.
him.
That's right. He beat Vargas. And, but as far as the Mexicans are concerned, they didn't respect him.
Now they do. Okay. Yeah. Today, there's a kid named Canelo. What do you think about him?
I don't know anything about him.
That's him right there. Yeah. The redhead.
Oh, yeah, I heard about
this
guy.
He's 22 years old.
I saw him fight, man. He's a damn good fighter. Yeah,
he beat Shane Mosley recently.
Right. That's right.
He's the future.
But Mosley is over the hill, though. You know that, though, man. What's the guy, 39, 38?
No, he's done. He's retired. He's 40.
Yeah, he's finished. Yeah, I saw this guy. He kind of reminds me of a young Chavez. You know, with that facial features and all of that.
He was never an amateur fighter. Mm-hmm. Started fighting at 15 and has never lost.
Yeah, he's a good... I saw him. Now I know who you're talking about.
His name is Canelo Alvarez.
Right.
Canelo means cinnamon.
On Fox fight. Yeah, he's a tough-looking fighter, man.
So there you have it. VegasNewsReport.com. I'm Ali Sekback reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback.